Chapter 2, Generalizations, An Introduction, from A Workbook for Arguments by Morrow and Weston. Some arguments present one or more examples that they then use to support a generalization as their conclusion. This kind of argument is very common. Given this, it's really important to understand how arguments that use generalizations work, as well as to know what makes a good argument from generalization, as well as what makes an argument less good, or perhaps even bad. So let's look at an example. Women in earlier times were married very young. Juliet, in Shakespeare's Romeo and Juliet, was not even 14 years old. In the Middle Ages, 13 was the normal age of marriage for a Jewish woman. And during the Roman Empire, many Roman women were married at age 13 or younger. Okay, if we're going to identify the premises and conclusions in this argument, we're going to come up with something like this. So, we'll see that the conclusion is women in earlier times were married very young, and then we have three examples of this that conclusion is generalized from. To see the form of this argument most clearly, let's look at it in the proper order. So first, Juliet in Shakespeare's play was not even 14 years old. Jewish women during the Middle Ages were normally married at 13. Many Roman women during the Roman Empire were married at age 13 or younger. And from this, we generalize the conclusion, therefore, women in earlier times were married very young. Now, the question to ask yourself when you're using arguments that involve generalizations is when do premises adequately support generalizations? One requirement, of course, is that your examples are accurate. If Juliet wasn't around 14, or if most Roman or Jewish women weren't married at 13 or younger, then notice that this argument is much weaker. If none of the premises can be supported, there's no argument at all, in fact. So to check an argument's examples or to find good examples for your own arguments, sometimes it's important to do research. In fact, I changed that. I wouldn't say sometimes. I would say all of the time. As we'll see later in the quarter, a faulty generalization is an example of a logical fallacy that involves generalizing from improper premises. A few final words. Note that even when all of the examples that you're using are accurate, generalizing from a set number of examples to a conclusion can be tricky business. The rules in this chapter are going to offer a sort of checklist for assessing arguments that use generalization.